everybody, my name is Vinu Venkatesh and welcome to another session with me on the English language for SAI Education Group. We're going to continue with prepositions, so this would be lecture 30. So I say we start. All right, so let's get started right away. My younger sister has developed a passion - dance music since her childhood. It's not in, it's not with, it's not on. It's not to, but it is for. It's a passion for something. It is always a passion for something. I have a passion for cooking. It's not, I cannot say, it is wrong to say I have a passion with cooking or a passion in cooking or passion on cooking or passion to cooking. It is always passion for, all right? Passion is always followed by the preposition for. Always remember that. Next, it does not matter whether the movie is in Hindi or English. I am - at ease. I'm - ease with these languages. All right. Now, whenever you're using ease, it is always I am with ease. It's not I am at ease or I am on ease. It is a preposition phrase. It is always I am with ease with doing something. All right. I'm in ease. That is also wrong. So it's always I am with ease. I'm with ease. With these languages. Next, my friend hardly attends any function as he is jealous - all the neighbors. It is always jealous of. So jealous is always followed by the preposition of. Always remember that. Okay. Next, the use of atomic weapons will be baneful - the mankind. Baneful means harmful, okay? So what kind of preposition should we use? Should it be from, of, with, to, or on? It should be to. Why? Because the adjectives baneful, harmful, pernicious, which also means harmful, detrimental, and injurious, which also means, injurious. This should be injurious, not inurious. Injurious are always followed by the preposition to. This is something that you have to memorize. There's no other way about it, all right? The lower court acquitted him - the crime, but another case was filed against him. Now, always remember, acquit means to release. So whenever, the preposition that we have to use with verbs such as acquit, release, charge, accuse, they're always followed by the preposition of. So the answer here would be of. All right. The lower court acquitted him of the crime, but another case was filed against him. Listening to his story is akin - reading a good adventure novel. Is it of, by, with, in, or to? Now, akin means similar. So words such as akin, similar, equivalent, and tantamount. Tantamount also means equivalent or similar, are always followed by the preposition to. So listening to his story is akin to reading a good adventure novel. All right. Don't go by his appearance. He's capable - accomplishing any task without any support. Now this should be easy because we always say he's capable of, not capable to or by or with or in. It is always capable of. That must be very simple. I'm sure you guys got this right. All right. Next. See, some things you just have to memorize. So there are no further explanations for prepositions. In case of prepositions, there are a lot of rules. There are exceptions which you have to memorize and get used to. All right. The lawyer was not well acquainted - new rules, thereby lost the case. Acquainted means to be, familiar with or to be well aware of. So the verb acquaint is always followed by the preposition with. Familiar, which is also similar in meaning to acquaint, however, is followed by the preposition to. And aware, which also is similar in meaning to acquaint, is followed by the preposition of. Always remember. Suppose I said the lawyer was not familiar to new rules, thereby lost the case. The lawyer was not aware of the new rules, thereby lost the case. But here it is acquainted, and therefore the preposition should be with. The lawyer was not well acquainted with new rules, thereby lost the case. All right. The painter painted beautiful paintings - brushes and paints. All right. Is it from, by, with, in, or of? Now, there is a rule to remember. Whenever we are talking about painting, all right, or we use a preposition with in case we are talking about instruments. But if we are talking about painting done by a person, then the preposition should be by. So here, we have instruments, that is brushes and paints. So the preposition here should be with. The painter painted beautiful paintings with brushes and paints. Okay. Suppose if I want to say the beautiful paintings were painted dash the painter. It should be the beautiful paintings were painted by the painter. Why by? Because it's a person. That's a rule that we have to remember. All right. All the time the avaricious king was blind dash the sufferings of his men. Avaricious means greedy. Now, here also we have some rules. Now, with the word blind, we use a preposition in case it is, we are talking about physical blindness. Suppose if we are talking about the cause of blindness, then we use a preposition by. For example, one can be blinded by a drop of acid. Okay, because it's a cause of blindness. Acid is a cause of blindness. Drop of acid can cause blindness. He was blind in the left. So when we're talking about a physical blindness which already exists, then we use in. So here, what is the meaning of the sentence? All the time the avaricious king was blind dash the sufferings of his men. So here blind has a different meaning. Blind here means ignorant. When we're talking about blind as ignorant, then we have to use to. So all the time the avaricious king was blind to the sufferings of his men. But if we talk about blind in the actual sense of the word, then we have to follow these rules. The little boy parted dash all his possessions before going to hostel. Okay. Now what preposition do we use here? Now with the verb parted, okay, in case we are using the verb parted to indicate separation from objects or things, then we use the preposition with. But if we are using the verb parted to indicate separation from people, then we use the preposition from. So in this case, we have to use a preposition with, because we are talking about parting from all his possessions. Possessions are things. So the little boy parted with all his possessions before going to hostel. Red wine is vintage as it is made dash enriched grapes and apples. Now, with the word make or made, preposition of is used when the state of ingredients is unchanged. That is, the ingredients used to make something, when it is unchanged, then make or any form of the verb make is followed by the preposition of. But when the state of ingredients is changed, then the verb make or any of its forms is followed by the preposition from. So in this case, we all know that red wine is made from grapes, but the grapes, in this case, grapes and apples. So, but the grapes and apples will change their form in order to form liquid. From solid, they become liquid. So we have to say made from. All right. Next, at the restaurant, my wife ordered dash a plate of biryani. Now, here, do we use preposition for, to, with, in, of, or no preposition required? The answer is no preposition is required, because between the verb order and an object, there is no preposition that is required. If the verb order is used as a noun, then it should be followed by the preposition for. Okay, very simple. Now here, after the verb order, there is an object. What is that? A plate of biryani. So whenever there is an object directly after the verb ordered, then we do not use a preposition. All right. She quit her job as her career was beset dash difficulties. Beset means, what should I say, team or infected with or infest, right? Like what's given here, beset, team, infest, swamp, fraught. What do they mean? For example, when we say stagnant, when we see stagnant water lying on the ground during rainy season in Kerala, sometimes we see a lot of insects in it, a lot of mosquitoes. So we say that the water is the stagnant water is beset with insects, means it is full of insects. So beset, team, infest, swamp and fraught, they all mean the same thing. They are always followed by the preposition with. The verb beset can also be followed by the preposition by when the cause of difficulty is specified. By the way, there is a typo here. I've mentioned it as best. It should be beset. So what is it saying? So whenever we are given the cause of the difficulty, then beset should be followed by the preposition by. But if no cause is given, it should be followed by the preposition with. So here there is no cause given. It just says beset dash difficulties. So it should be with difficulties. Suppose it is given, she quit her job as her career was beset dash COVID. So COVID is a reason, it's a cause. So we should use a preposition by. Was beset by COVID means her career was infected, infested, or you know, destroyed because of COVID. All right, last example. She succumbed dash temptation and ate plenty of ice creams at a time. Succumb means to give in. All right, so succumb, surrender, and yield all mean the same thing, and they're always followed by the preposition to. So she succumbed to temptation and ate plenty of ice creams at a time. So this is a reference from where I got all these examples. You can always check it out. Please do practice as much as possible. Prepositions generally have more rules and exceptions which you have to memorize. So all the best, and see you again next time. Until then, take care, and please do take things seriously and practice. Bye-bye.